you for giving me this.
I am calling Sri A.B. Ekajam to please speak.
Thank you for this time. As I get up to speak on a troublesome moment in the history of India that has never happened, called the tragedy of Manipur, which is sought to be silenced by the government, and it is an irony, gets an opportunity as the midnight hour approaches. And this reminds me of the fact that people in my home state, the time is 2 hours ahead of Delhi. And we have been dancing on the tune of Delhi and the time that is supposed to be approaching 12 at the moment. People like Janu Barua and others have demanded for years that notice the priority that I can sense is this moment that I... Mr. Speaker, sir, I'm just trying to... Mr. Chairman, I'm drawing your attention to the absence of Manipur in the President's address. This is not a simple absence. It is a reminder of a Rashtra Chetna which excludes people. You must realize that more than 60,000 people are languishing in relief camp in a wretched conditions for the last 1 year. If anybody has read partition of this subcontinent, which I have done, I was associated with a research project. We have interviewed more than 1,500 survivors of partition of 1947, and you are witnessing the same thing. People are living in a wretched conditions that I cannot even mention here. 60,000 people homeless is not a joke. 200 plus people died. And there has been a civil war-like situations where people are armed to the teeth and roaming around and fighting each other, defending their villages. And the Indian state is a mute spectator to this tragedy for 1 year. I must remind this House that each and every square centimeter of Manipur is covered by a Central Armed Forces. It is one of the most militarized areas in this country where you have more armed policemen than the civil police, besides the armed forces of the Union. Despite this, how is that 60,000 people were rendered homeless and villages, thousands were destroyed? And yet, our Prime Minister remained mute, not even a word. And the presidential address did not even mention that.
Shame.
And I said that this silence is not normal. It is a reminder of the fact which many scholars have said, that there is a continuity between colonial and the post-colonial period. Today we are observing a day where we begin a new criminal laws, seemingly discarding heritage. But as Ashish Nandi says, colonialism is a state of mind. It is a psychological phenomenon. It is an outlook, the way you look at the people, the way you look at the world. And the fact that this continuity is shown by neglecting the tragedy of a state, which is the 19th state of the Union, it is amazing to see that I get an opportunity as the midnight hour approaches to register this anguish and this hurt of the denial that this country has meted out to its own citizens in the state of Manipur. Is this silence communicating to the people of the Northeast and Manipur in particular that you don't matter in the Indian state's scheme of things? Major Lysham Jotin, who was awarded Ashok Chakra while grappling with suicide bomber, was a Manipuri. Who was awarded Ashok Chakra, you are dishonoring his own state. Major Ngangum Joy Dutta, who was awarded Veer Chakra while fighting for this country and doing his duty as a part of the peacekeeping force in Sri Lanka in 1987. You are dishonoring this man. You are dishonoring the likes of the youths who hoping. Major Lysham Jotin, who was awarded Ashok Chakra while grappling with suicide bomber, was a Manipuri. Who was awarded Ashok Chakra, you are dishonoring his own state. Major Ngangum Joy Dutta, who was awarded Veer Chakra while fighting for this country and doing his duty as a part of the peacekeeping force in Sri Lanka in 1987. Mary Combs, Sarita Kunjarani, and Mirabai Chanu, you are saying that you don't matter in this country. You're Stram Sham Sharma don't matter in this country. If you have an iota of concern for this state, there would not have been a silence. There would not have been a silence in this house. Nor in the presidential address.
Yes, shame.
This must be registered.
Please raise your point of order.
If you wanted to doubt the nationality and the nationalism of the people of that state, you must realize that these people have fought for the country. These people have brought plural to this country. Please remember this. And that is what the silence means.
One second.
क्या बात कर रहे हो?
And I am telling you this.
हो सकता है? मैरी कॉम को हमने मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट बनाया. भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट बनाया. हमने कैसे नहीं इज्जत दी मणिपुर को? मणिपुर को स्पोर्ट्स यूनिवर्सिटी दिया. और आप सा जो है, मैं एक ऐसा आदमी हूँ कि मेरे मामा को मणिपुर में गोली लगी. वो सीआरपीएफ के डीआईजी थे. इनको शहीद नहीं पता है. और 1956 में पहला आपसा मणिपुर में लगा. और 1956 से आज तक
उसके
कारण मणिपुर की यह स्थिति है.
5 years after independence, can you negate this fact? We are talking about the inclusion of the Northeast history after 75 years. That's a classic exclusion. India was an anthropological subject, not a historical subject in the eyes of the colonial forces. And today, the Northeast remains outside of the history of the Indian. You treat them as the other. And that's the silence. And the silence on the Manipur tragedy is not unique. It is a reflection of this general continuity of the colonial in the post-colonial. It is sad to see.
Sir,
a nationalist party
Please
like
conclude.
The BJP will Sir, feel comfortable with the silence this, on the tragedy of Manipur. Keep your house, hands on your heart and think about the 60,000 people who are linguistic in relief camps.
No.
And those mothers, those widows, think of them. And then you talk about nationalism.
Point is made. He made
Only
his
then
point.
We will understand what this tragedy means. And Mr. Chairman, the hurt, the anger has thrown a nobody like me to be part of this temple of democracy. Beating the BJP cabinet minister, think about the pain. If you hear an anxiety, anguish, and pain in my voice, please go back and see those 60,000 people languishing in the relief camp. Don't talk about partition remembrance till you bring that. I would keep going the moment the Prime Minister opened his mouth and a nationalist party says that Manipur is part of India and we care for the people of that state. Only then I will accept what is nationalism in our face. As I get up to speak on a
परजीवी बन चुकी और अपने सहयोगी दलों के कंधे पर उन्होंने चढ़ करके ये सीटों का आंकड़ा बढ़ाया है. अगर कांग्रेस ने अपने सहयोगियों के जो वोट खाए हैं वो अगर न खाए होते तो लोकसभा में उनके लिए इतनी सीटें जीत पाना भी बहुत मुश्किल था। आदरणीय सभापति जी, ऐसे समय एक अवसर आया, देश ने